Welcome, welcome, welcome back to the workshop on this frozen day. It is 19 below zero this morning. It is super, super cold, but we're heating it all up. We're ready to go surfing with Ed Big Daddy Roth's Surfink from Atlantis. This is in stock right now at modelroundup.com. I will put a link down in the description where you can snag this and plenty of other awesome Atlantis kits from modelroundup.com. Sweet retro box art. It makes a little diorama. You saw me build the other one, Mr. Gasser. Had a blast doing that my own way. Now we're gonna be putting together the Surfink, very, very popular kits on there. The box art, they do the old style box art from when Revell had the molds. Gives you a rundown of the model, lets you know it's 7 inches tall, only has 18 parts in the box. So let's take a look at what's going to be in the box when you get yours. First up will be parts of that wave motion body. I love that it makes a diorama. We're going to get to paint this up. You're going to see me detail this and show you how to make it look somewhat like water out of plastic. We'll have a good time. We got the fin for the surfboard right there. We got really cool water texture on all these parts. It is all molded in white styrene, so you won't have to worry about covering up any colors. We got the nice wave action. We got some of the front curl. We've got crabs. I've got crabs. A crab, one piece molded. Nice detail on there, underneath and everything. We got the tongue. This is disgusting. The tongue for the Surfink, though this would be great for grabbing hamburger patties. Grab onto it, swallow them. The hands are one piece. You're gonna have to do a little bit of model knife cleanup around there. Not a big deal. You can see a little bit of tiny bit of flash on the crab. Your crab's kind of flashy. We got the cool looking surfboard, which is ready for some custom painting. Got all your outlines done and everything on it. Bottom is smooth. Got our fin down there. These are older molds, so they will require just a tad bit of cleanup of flash. It's not a big deal. That's why they made this invention. Got the hair, the feet, the arms. Look at all the cool little like indentations. So you can paint in the darker hairs or wash it to make it look a little more realistic. And finally, the Surfink himself. We can see the size of that kit. Nice big kit. Detail, got his Bahama shorts on, Bermuda shorts. Is that what they're called? Is that what you funky kids are calling them? His hairstyle. Got his buttocks, got a pocket back there. All cool looking, you can see the detail on this side really well. All textured in, will accept a wash or some detailing. On the other side of the table, not much to look at. We've got a little selection of decals. We got some eyeball decals, we got some Maltese crosses and the Surfink logo. We've got a one sheet instruction manual. That's how simple the kit is to put together. Very vintage. Right off the old style, tells you how to put everything together. And that's what we're going to get to next. I'm going to start assembling my kit and we'll be right back. Thank you. Within a very short time period, we're looking at an assembled Surfink surfboard and wave, so we can take a look at that. As you can see, he's not glued together at all. He's just sitting there on his own, and you saw me push it together for the assembly. If you don't want to do a lot of sanding and stuff, the seams aren't extremely bad, and I'm not going to worry about them. I never really worry about them at all, but you can see we got some seam line in here around the back of the ear. The top of the head will be covered by the hair. Around the arm, down the arm, you can see how the glue fills that in quite well. Even this long, smooth seam along the shorts, around the leg and down. The feet help hold the body together. And then we've got another seam coming up, but it goes right along the seam of the shorts and then up underneath and around the arm, up over the shoulder. I'm not going to concern myself with any of those. They look fine. You don't have to glue the arm or the hands into position. Now, I didn't glue the hands in, but I'll get them painted up with everything and then I can detach them. You can see they'll just slide in and out. So I can get in here and paint and work around it. But the arm I glued in solid, you don't have to. It will go up and down if you want it to, if you disassemble it that way. That loop part that I thought was part of a wave or the crest of the wave is actually the inside of his mouth. So don't forget to put that in against the back. In the instructions, it's not extremely clear, but it is in there. Shows it right back here that that should go into the mouth. And that's the back of his mouth. And then we've got all of our joints together and everything. And then the arm pushes in. So you saw that when we're assembling it. And that's where that part goes. Be careful when you're working on things. We don't want to break teeth off. They can be glued back on. But who wants to mess with that? So this is the Surfink. The feet are glued in place. And we'll be using them to sit on those feet so we can get them primed and first color coat painted. And then the rest will all be done with dry brushing and detail brushing and all that. So I didn't even notice he's got little nips going on there. Nice detailed hands. Just a little bit of cleanup. Careful when you clean him up. His nails are supposed to be very ragged on the ends there. So you don't want to shave those or smooth those out unless you want them to look smooth. But they are very jagged and beat up like one of those, you know, disgusting people would always have like that. We've got the crab and the tongue, which are going to start out the same basic colors with a pinkish red tone. So we'll leave those on the same tree. The hair, I want to do different than the body tone. So we'll do those separately. We got the surfboard, which just lays in that wave there. That we can hold on to by the fin and start painting that up. And then with those large lines in there, we should be able to hand paint some flames and stuff and get those on there. And then the wave. The wave's got a couple of seams. If you felt like closing them in, I just sealed them with super glue gel. And that's as far as I'm gonna worry about it. We'll get this painted up with a base blue color over the primer, and then we will start dry brushing and detail that to get some foam, get some waves and all that stuff. So I'm gonna head over to the paint area and I'll see you there.
Thank you. Thank you.
And after that nice long detail section showing you pretty much how I did the entire kit from front to back in this video, as the back comes around to us, we are all done with Ed Big Daddy Roth's Dinghead Gremmy, the Surfink, reissued by Atlantis Model Kits, sent to the show by modelroundup.com. Jack Kirk over there, modelroundup.com, they've got this kit available right now, and I will link down below where you can snag your own. Enjoy painting it up in your way. Decorate it. Now, I did go with some of the box art as far as the orangish skin and the surfer blonde, bleach blonde hair over the darker hairstyle, but then I went different with the surfboard. I went different with the shorts. I went different with the crab than what the box art shows, because it's my model and I want to build it that way. I enjoyed myself quite a bit. You could see how easy it is to make white plastic look like water. We got the blue base coat, then we dry brush some stuff. We got the high gloss on the surfboard and on the crab because they're wet. I brushed the gloss in the eyes and in the mouth and on the tongue. I think that's a tongue. We must use those suction cups to get the crabs up so we can chomp on them and eat them. So then why not? It's biting his toe anyways. That's how I set it up on here. And I just think these are so much fun. Now, I built the other one where he's sitting on top of the gasser and cruising down the road. This one, a little more of a favorite for me because it's so different and I like water. I like ocean stuff. I like surfer stuff. This one's really cool and the figure turned out very easily. You can still see my seams on this one. You can go ahead and fill them in if you want, but they aren't terrible at all. I mean, even the long seam on the side, see how it's pretty much just covered up with paint and glue. It's pretty easy to put together this kit. It's not hard at all. Anyone could do it and then paint it the way that you want to because it is yours. As always, remember, it's your hobby. It's your model kit and you should smile and have a great time. Thanks for all your support. Thanks for the nice comments and questions below. I read every single one, even if I don't get a chance to reply to them because of time constraints. And as always, we thank longtime channel supporter Model Roundup. If you want cool stuff like this sticker, or you want a button or some magnets, they have this kind of stuff available on their website called the Swag Pack. It's limited edition, so when they're gone, they're all gone. But go on there, search for it, pick one up for yourself. You can get cool stuff like that when you're buying your Surfink model kit. Thanks to all of you. We'll see you at the next review.